Hello everyone, this is new chapter of bond valuation that I am starting here. Bond as worth showing is something which is related to long term. These are the learning objectives that will help you to understand that what concepts we will cover, understand the valuation of bonds, how to calculate price, understand the concept of coupon rate and investor required return, understand the impact of investor required return and coupon rate on bond price, understand various types of bonds, understand the concept of rate of return. Whenever we discuss bond, it means that this is the security that obligates the issuer to make a specified payments to the bondholder. Suppose a company required certain amount and the company is planning to issue bond certificates, then these bonds will be bought by various investors. A general public can buy, a company can also buy. So whoever is buying these bonds will be able to receive some interest payment, and this payment will come on normally on an annual basis or on a half yearly basis. But whenever you are buying bond, it means that after certain time period you will be able to recover the par value of the bond, and if the maturity of the bond is 3 years, then you will receive the par value at the end of the third year. If the maturity time is 5 years, then you will be able to get this payment after 5 years, and so on. Price is present value of bond after discounting all future cash flows. Whenever we are using term coupon rate, it means that this is the interest payment as a percentage of face value. Later on, you will see that how we will calculate it. This is the current yield, present return on the basis of coupon payment and current price of bond. YTM or yield to maturity is the investor required rate on bond trading in the secondary market. Remember, this is one of the important term that we will use in the entire chapter. So the concept of coupon rate and the concept of yield to maturity should be very clear. If you have any confusion after this lecture, then you can put it on comments, then I'll try to explain it. Yield to call is investor required return on a callable bonds. These are the bonds that have a certain maturity time, but being an investor, you can redeem the bond before time. In simple words, a company has this option when they are offering these bonds, that they can take it back from the investor before the maturity time. Suppose a bond has a maturity time of 5 years and company is planning to buy it back after 2 years. So this option, if given in the bond, then we call it a callable bonds. There is difference between bonds and loans. Loans, two parties involved, and in bonds, three parties involved. In loan, you or your company will go to the bank and will deal with them, and whatever amount you need, you will discuss and negotiate all these things with your bankers. So there are two parties involved. In bond, three parties involved: public, bank, and company. So this is the structure that will happen. So company need fund, bank will provide services as an intermediary, and public will invest to get interest. So this is the reverse function. Company will pay back interest to the bank, and bank will give it to the public either in cash form or credit to the account. Interest is fixed on bonds, whatever decided at the initial stage. Once company is announcing their bond, at that time they committed in terms of coupon rate that this is the interest payment we will make on these bonds. While the interest is negotiable between borrower and lender in case of loan, it is not earlier decided. It is decided during the negotiation. Once it is done, then being a financier, bank is aware that how much and what rate of interest they will charge on a certain loan. Face value is fixed in bonds, but in case of loan, there is no fixed value. It's up to you. You can take a loan of 1 lakh or 2 million, 5 million, or whatever amount you are deciding. This is the first question. Based on this question, you will get the idea that how a bond market is functioning. This question is only giving you idea of interest payment. Let's say we have a bond of 5 years with a coupon rate of 4% and has a face value of 1,000. You can keep it in any currency, irrespective of you are working in dollars, you are working in Australian currency, you are working in UK, you are working in India or in Pakistan or whatever country you name it. But the face value will remain 1,000, irrespective of you are working on a basic question or working on an advanced question. So this will help you a lot, that whenever we are discussing face value or par value, it will remain 1,000. So this RS is not important. The important thing is to keep it in mind that we will base our bond at a value of 1,000. What is the annual interest payment? So 5-year bond means company is committing that whatever fund they are taking from the investor, they will pay 4% interest to these investors every year. And at the end of the 5th year, company is committed to pay back face value back to investor. So this is the structure will come. If you are interested to find out what interest amount you will receive every year, so this is the working that will occur. 1,000 is the face value. The coupon rate which is given in the question will be applied on this, and then you can simply apply it on your calculator and you can get the amount of 40. TMT stands for that this amount will be treated as annuity and this amount will continue for the next 5 years unless the maturity time is ends. So this timeline will help you to understand that what I'm trying to explain you, that each year you will be able to receive this 40 amount. So this is the interest payment which will be received by investor from the company. Why this amount is happening for 5 years? Because bond has a maturity time of 5 years. Let's say over here that the bond maturity time is 3 years, then this amount will end over here. If this maturity time is going to 10 years, then this bond will remain continue for the next 10 years. But what will happen at the end of the 5th year? Will you get back your own amount? Yes. This amount will come at the end of the maturity time. And of course, it is possible that you bought from the market at 900 or 1150, or you bought it at 850, irrespective of whatever amount you paid to hold this bond. But at the time of maturity, company is committed to pay back the face value. Now see that this question is the starting point. This is the first question in which we will try to calculate the price of the bond. So if you are interested to calculate price of the bond, you need to develop a certain data. And see that in this question, we have 3-year bond and 10% is coupon rate. So now I think that the student should be familiar that what is meant by coupon rate. If you are get confused, then you can go back to the previous few minutes back and check the video again. But this coupon rate is showing that a company is committed to pay 10% interest payment each year. And yield to maturity is showing that investor required return from this bond is 8%. This is the investor return which they are demanding, and see carefully that company is paying more than what is demanded by the investor. So this is the data which will establish N is 3 years. Coupon rate is 10%, face value 1,000, YTM is 8% as given over here. So we will use this to understand this structure. Now, again, raising a question for your understanding that why it is appearing to 3 intervals. So if you go back to the previous slide, you can see that 3 years is appearing because we are working on a 3-year bond. and you will get this 100 each year. As I discussed earlier, that you have a 10% coupon, this coupon rate will be applied on this par value. So if you take this 10%, apply on this 1000, your calculator will give you answer of 100. This is the interest payment which I tried to explain in the previous question. So this interest payment is arising here as 100 each year that you will be able to get. If you carefully check it, this is showing an annuity amount. So this annuity will be discounted and we will bring it at present value. To discount it, we use this formula. See over here, we have PMT. This is the PMT that you are receiving here. YTM, which is given in question, and that is 8%. So, and by using the annuity formula, you can get the answer, and that answer is arising this much. Carefully see that if you are applying an annuity formula or whatever annuity formula you use, your answer should be similar to 257. If it is not coming, then recheck your formula. It might be possible that you are applying a negative sign. Rather than applying negative sign, if you are putting positive sign, then your answer will become wrong. So this will help you a lot. So again, go back to the time value of money, take practice from there, and then apply over here. As we discussed that you within these 3 years, you will be able to receive these three amounts. And at the end of the last year, you will get the face value from the company. This face value that you will receive at the end of the third year should also be discounted and bring back to the present value to find the total value that is coming at zero time. If you get the sum of these two amount, the price is coming 1051. This is very interesting that why this amount is appearing more than face value. This I'm going to explain later on, but right now you can see that if you are interested to find out price of the bond, you can simply apply a discount factor on all the cash flow that you are receiving as well as face value. Now again, showing you in the next slide that how actually in simple terms we are working on this one. We are applying payment, we are applying investor required rate of return, we are taking the number of maturity years over here, face value that you will receive at the end of the third year, over here you are applying the present value formula, and you are getting price of 1051. In the next lectures, I will further explain all these concepts on Excel spreadsheet. So if you subscribe the channel, then you will be able to access all those lectures which will present the entire working on a spreadsheet, and that becomes your life very easier. The bond is at premium. When we can call it at premium? When price of the bond is coming more than the face value, as you can see it yourself. Showing you over here again, current price is 1051. As you calculated, face value is 1000. So this is the situation which is arising over here. And this situation can be explained with the help of this structure, that the current price is coming 1051, while the face value is 1000. So can I say that actually you are working on this concept, that whenever YTM is less than coupon rate, I'm reminding you, whenever investor required return given in the question is less than coupon rate which is offered by the company, bond will always be offered at premium, at discount. This is reverse of the previous question. Similar calculations will be applied, as I discussed earlier, that if you have to apply calculation yourself, then hold your video over here. Go back to the previous work, check the price formula of the bond valuation and apply it here. It will help you a lot to check yourself that whether you can calculate it or not. And once you are satisfied, then you can go to the further video. But I'm showing you over here. In this question, we have 3 year bond. Now the coupon rate is 8% while YTM is 10%. Student, this is important. So those students who want to practice this and they have to make very perfect in this one, they will always check it in their question that what coupon rate is offered by the company and what is investor required return. These two are very, very important thing to understand the basic theme behind the price mechanism of the bond question. So right now, check this one. This coupon rate is 8%, while YTM is 10%. So under this situation, if we are working, applying the same formula, then this is the answer which will arise. Now carefully see that now the price of the bond is not more than par value. It is below the par value. The reason behind it, as you will show, you will see in the next slide, but I'm showing it here that this bond is at discount. Why? Why it is not appearing at premium? Reason is appearing over here. See, current price is less than face value. Under this situation, we call that bond is offered at discount. So this again, for your convenience, that how it is appearing, the price that you calculated yourself was 950, which is less than 1000. And under what condition this will happen, carefully check this one. This is very important for you. Whenever investor required return is greater than coupon rate, go back to your question, check yourself. If investor required return or YTM is greater than coupon rate, then bond will always be remain in the market at discount. Third condition, which is very interesting but very easy to understand, and even some of my students verbally solve this question without any numerical support, because theoretically they should be so mature. So check it again. A 3-year bond with 8% coupon rate, face value of 1000, has the yield to maturity of 8%. Now the question is, company is offering 8% while yield to maturity is also showing the 8%. If both are showing the same rate, means investor is also demanding 8% while the company is offering the similar rate. In this situation, the data will be established like this. And if you check this data, you will see that again, the thing which is highlighting is that coupon rate and YTM both are same. So again, pointing out towards these two concepts, that these two concepts will help you to understand the mechanism behind the price of the bond. Again, you will apply the formula and you will calculate, but now look, a very interesting thing will appear. The price of the bond is equal to face value. Under what condition it is possible? This is the condition under which it is possible. When YTM is equal to coupon rate, the situation will remain same and the current price will be equal to face value. Student, there are two ways to understand the bond chapter. One, through slide, where you can understand the theme of the chapter, and then on the Excel sheet. If you subscribe the channel, like it, then I'll present you the entire chapter on Excel, where you will see that how easily we can calculate prices, we can understand the mechanism, and simultaneously you will be able to understand how we use different formulas on the Excel. Thank you. Thank you very much.